Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing this look on the dun, 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 Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. Everyone's been talking about this palette and I thought I would do a look on it. It's quite basic and simple and I'm wearing it all day. So I thought I would do that. Yeah, so carry on watching to see how I achieve this look. Welcome back to my channel. As you can tell from today's title, I am going to be doing a Modern Renaissance Anastasia Beverly Hills look. It's not a first impressions because, as you can see, I've used it loads and loads of times and loads and loads of people have used it and reviewed it. But I just thought I wanted to dedicate a video because when I look at it, I always just see the reds and there is quite a lot of neutral shades in there as well. So I wanted to try and do something a little bit different. Also, I've already prepped my my skin's already done because I'm doing a first impression on the Kat Von D Locket Foundation, so that should be live as well. So let's dive into the video. I've already primed my eyelids. I just did it with concealer with the Urban Decay concealer. So I'm gonna go straight in with the Renaissance palette, and I'm gonna use Burnt Orange, but with the Sigma E70 brush, and it's angled. So that is just Burnt Orange. The only thing I will say is that I've not heard in reviews is that when I go into it, it's left a big dent. Can you see? And I only go in lightly, so I don't know if that's just me. Anyway, with the same brush, I'm gonna go in with Raw Sienna, just in the crease. There we go. So it's just to bind it a little bit, give it a bit of dimension. Now, I did say I wanted to keep it very neutral. I wanted to show that you don't have to gravitate towards the red. So if this isn't the video for you, I'm really sorry about that. It's just, I really do get scared with the reds. I will maybe post another video, like an Anastasia Modern Renaissance part 2, and actually go in with the reds, but I'm not very confident. I don't think my makeup's good enough for that. So I'm just gonna go in with a clean Morphe brush. It's in their ice set. It's like Ice Lay or something like that, I'm not sure. But it's just like a fluffy brush, that's what it is really. And I'm just gonna blend it. There we go. Right, now I'm gonna go in with, actually, I'm just gonna go with that. I'm just gonna do some shimmer. I'm gonna go in with Primavera. Is it called Primavera? That one there. And I'm actually gonna use my finger. I haven't used my finger for ages on eyeshadow. And I'm not sure why, because it does pick up the best pigment. I'm just gonna do that. So I'm just gonna do one swipe. Don't use their finger for a shimmer, because when people do like swatches on the hands, they're using the finger, they're using your fingers, and you're getting the best pigmentation. So for a shimmer, in like, especially, I'm just surprised people don't use. that is it for the for the eyeshadow palette for now, and I only did use 3 shadows, so it is quite good. I mean, even if you didn't want to buy the whole palette, you could just get them 3 shades and it's just a classic look. But yeah, that's some shades for that. Next, I'm gonna go in with, oh, I have already done my brows already. I just use my Precisely My Brow, like I always do. Today I'm gonna go in with Bad Girl. There we go, like my lashes, and I'm not going to put any false lashes on today because that's why I've used this mascara, so I wouldn't have it. I'm going to do my face. I'm going to bronze my face with the Marc Jacobs Tan Tanic bronzer. I do want to get the rose gold packaging, even though I know it's the same one. I just really like it. It's so beautiful, like the packaging. So I'm going to go in with the blush brush from Real Techniques. Now the reason why I've done such a basic look is because I am still reviewing that Kat Von D, so I wanted to wear something I could wear all day. So that's that. Today for my cheek, my blush, sorry, and my highlight, I'm going to use the Jaclyn Hill Becca palette collection, champagne collection palette. This one here, no one uses it anymore. And I don't know why. Look, oh god, you can see myself. So yeah, I'm just gonna go in with Pumpernickel, I think it's called. No, Rosé Spritz, the shimmery one. And I'm gonna just use this, just to save time. There we go. Just gives a nice shimmery blush. There we go. Now, I tried a trick yesterday. I went out yesterday, it was like an all day thing, and I tried a trick where I just used my sponge to do the highlight, and it actually works. I thought it worked quite well. So I'm gonna go in with, so I can't remember which one's which. I'm gonna go in with Champagne Pot, which is the pinkier one. Look at all that product you get. And I'm literally just gonna do the cheek, here, and then like a little bit here. I wouldn't recommend using the sponge for those highlights. It kind of went down like that, so. But I'm gonna try and make it work. So that's that. Now I'm gonna set everything with the Too Faced Hangover 3-in-1 Replenish Primer and Setting Spray. Now I've really been loving this. I bought this for my birthday last year and haven't really been using it because I've been using the MAC Fix Plus and the Urban Decay. So I've just really started using this again, so. because it's coconutty. I don't know if that's just me. The lip combo I'm going to be doing today is, it is Primark a lip liner pencil in biscuit, which is just a nude, but then it's Gerard Cosmetics lipstick and buttercup. I love this lip combo. I think it's beautiful. There you go. I think it does look really beautiful. So that is my look with the Modern Renaissance palette. Sorry I'm wearing a cardigan, I know it doesn't look flattering on camera, but it's all of a sudden gotten really cold in Northern Ireland, so kind of have to do that. Hope you really enjoyed this. I am going to do a part two and use the reds. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I don't forget to like, subscribe, and don't forget to put the bell on as well if you want to be first to know about when I upload and stuff like that. I am going to do a schedule. I think I'm going to do like Sundays, Tuesdays and Fridays, but that's only if I have three videos ready. If I don't, it will be like a Sunday or a Tuesday or a Sunday and a Friday or something like that, okay? So leave a comment in the description box below, and I will see you soon. Bye.